Hallo, guten Tag, Kameraden. Ich bin Stonetrooping, reenacting. Hey guys, so for today's video, we'll be going over something that's rather simple, however, rather very important. And I feel that a lot of reenactors do wrong, especially at events. And that is how to set up your field equipment. Now, overall, arranging your field equipment onto your belt is rather simple. However, where I see a lot of reenactors struggle is how to put on your field equipment. And for me personally, I have found the best way that works for me, and I believe that will work best for most reenactors, and is pretty much how guys back then did it. We'll be also be going over what I personally pack in my bread bag, and how I personally like to set up my gear when going to reenactments, but also kind of depends on the situation at hand. So without further ado, let's get into the video. You've all come around. Hey guys, so I have my field equipment all laid out. So this is what roughly your field equipment should look like. So your Zeltbond, however, can go either on your Y-straps like I have it, or on your field equipment. Of course, depending on the situation and reenactment, you might have more or less equipment on you than I have laid out right here. But overall, this is the basics of what you need. So let's get right into it. So here, guys, we now have all the belt stripped. And also, apologize in advance, my camera stand broke. So forgive me for any shaking. So we now have our first ammo pouch. So this ammo pouch, you're going to slide in the belt through the loops on the back. So through here and through here. Now, if you have brand new ammo pouches, I highly suggest removing that, and then take this part off, and then sliding in your belt and then reattaching it. However, since this is I've had this for a while, and I've also put leather lotion and all kinds of stuff, it's much softer, so it's much easier time just looping it through. So we now have the ammo pouches looped through. We will now put on the bread bag. So now we have our bread bag on, we also have our mess tin strap attached to our mess tin, attaching it to the bread bag, and our canteen. I will discuss later in the video of how to put this stuff on and what I pack in my bread bag. But let's move on to our spotten and our bayonet. So what you want to do is grab your belt, loop it through here, and then you're going to take that and then loop it through your bayonet frog. Now this is a bit difficult since I'm doing it one-handed, but there we go. And then you're going to put that through this loop. So I'll just pause it real quick and I'll put it on. Last but not least for the belt, we're going to be attaching the ammo pouches on there. So just get that on. Now for me personally, I prefer to have the Zeltbond rolled up on my Y-straps. Reason being is that whenever I have it on my belt, it overloads the belt, makes it kind of droopy. And overall, it just gets in the way. And I personally just like the look of it as well. So I put mine on my Y-straps. Now these are held on by these mess tin straps. And you can also loop it around the belt as well. However, with the belt, I do recommend using tornister straps. Now for the gas mask canister, there are several ways that you can wear it. However, I tend to have it strapped on the can via a mess tin strap, or you can have your gas cape bag attached to your strap. All right, we will now be going over how to attach your mess tin onto your bread bag. So first, you want to grab yourself your mess tin strap. Now, I personally recommend either Vincent's leather or Kelly's Military for their leather items. And at the front, it's kind of like hit or miss with their leather. However, for a mess tin strap, I do prefer at the fronts because it's a lot thinner. Whereas with these, they're a lot thicker. So, you know, you want your mess tin strap to actually fit through. So, that's just my personal little advice. But without further ado, let's get this on there. So, here then. Now, please forgive me. I'm doing it one hand. You want to grab the mess tin strap. And through that loop and through here. And then you're just going to run it through this right here, this little hole, and then you're going to buckle it together. And then there we go. Now, for me personally, I sometimes like to loop it around the bale because whenever you're out in the field, this tends to make a lot of noise. So if you strap it down, it keeps it still and then it won't ding up against your mess tin. Now, your canteen is a bit more simple. So you're simply just going to see this hook right here. You're going to hook that onto this ring right here. Now, a lot of renaturists just leave it like that. However, what that causes, this is going to start, you know, flopping around, making noise. But also, it starts to slowly tear away from the leather right here. So, the Germans were smart, and they had this strap that went underneath here, and it buckled up, buckled right here. And that way, it doesn't flop around as much, and you're not tearing this off right here. So, yep, that's how you get your mess tin and your canteen onto your bread bag. Now I'll be going over what I keep in my bread bag. All right, so not only we're going to do the bread bag, we're also going to be doing my mess tin. So let's start off with the mess tin. All right, so now my mess tin is now opened up. Let's go into what I have, or normally what I keep in here. So I normally have some sort of rag to wipe the inside of my mess tin, but also my mouth, etc. I have myself a Coca-Cola tin with some candies in there. Snacks. I have myself some sugar, some honey that decided to go all over the place inside my ditty bag. But this is with the original label, which is pretty cool, and some coffee. Last but not least, I have myself my ditty bag, what I keep this stuff in, that I'm now going to have to wash. So, but that's overall what I keep in my mess tin most of the time. Sometimes it changes, but let's move on to the bread bag. So it's a bit of a mess. However, we will be cleaning it up by putting it into my bread bag. So first, but not least, I got that reversed. First thing, we have ourselves my cleaning kit, rifle cleaning kit. This is the original one I got from International Military Antiques, IMA, dated 1938. See if it will focus. Oh well, it's not gonna focus. However, it is dated 1938. So I'll be putting that in here first. Have myself a post-war German Esbit stove with some reproduction Esbit tablets. Well, reproduction Esbit box, that is. And I'll be going in there second. Now, the reason why I put those in there first, because it allows to have a hard surface at the bottom of your bread bag, which kind of helps protect the rest of your stuff. Next, we have ourselves my sewing kit. This is a reproduction one that's going to be wrapped in my toque. Since it's the summertime, I'm not going to be using my toque, so I'm going to put it in my bread bag, and I'll wrap my sewing kit, so therefore, you know, the needles don't go around poking into my bread bag, which I've had happen. So be careful whenever you're reaching to your bread bag. If this is not secure, those freaking needles are gonna stab you. So I recommend wrapping it up into something. Next up, we have ourselves some post-war German gloves. These are pretty much identical to World War II time. And I got these from Kelly's Militaria. So I actually do plan on doing a video on these later on because I think they're just that good. But I normally would put these nets in my bread bag. However, during the winter time, I probably would be putting it probably last. That way, you know, it's ease of access. But since it's the summertime, I'm probably going to need these a little bit later. You know, I don't need it, you know, anytime soon. So, yep, that's what goes in there next, or just goes in my bread bag. Next up is my bread bag strap, my mosquito net, and then sometimes I put in my helmet cover in there, which is kind of a rarity to actually use it. However, if I were to bring it with me, it's probably going to be in some of my bread bag. Now, in order to close it, you just do your flap like that. Now, some people just call that a day. However, I personally like to button up the sides to make it more secure. So, yeah, you got this strap right here. You have this strap right here. You have a middle one as well. So, you know, it's really up to you whether or not you want to strap it up. For this video, we're just not going to do it. But I normally would strap up the sides. The middle one, you don't really have to do all that much. So, now that we have the bread bag and the mess tin strap out of the way, I'll be going over my shaving kit. Now, I know some guys are going to be using the shaving kit and using it, putting it into their bread bag. For me personally, I just keep it inside my toner stir for most of the time. However, I'm just going to show it off really quick. So right here, we have ourselves a toiletry bag from Wars and Shop. And also have ourselves a toiletry roll from Hessian Antique, which I highly recommend that you use. So here it is opened up. I have myself my shaving shave soap, comb, shave mirror, vintage razor, toothpaste from Wars and Shop, Odal mouthwash. I have razor blades in here. I have a little shaving brush. Over here, I have myself some hair tonic. Now, I know for us Americans, we typically use pomade, hair gel, all that kind of stuff. However, for guys back then in Germany, they used hair tonic. Stuff like pomade was just, it wasn't as common or pretty much at all in Germany during the time. But they used hair tonic a lot. I personally like it. I got this from the World War II soldier. Last but not least, I have myself a shave towel from Wars and Shop. So yeah, that's it for the shaving kit. So now we'll be going over how to put all of your gear on the proper way. So guys, we will now be putting on the field gear. So I am now going to be putting my thumbs where I want the hooks to be, so on the far end of the bread bag and in between the two loops of my bayonet and spotting carrier. We'll then use my thumbs to then put the back two hooks into those spots, letting my belt rest, and then putting in the hooks in the front in between the two straps of my K98 pouches. Lastly, we'll buckle in my belt. And then rearranging my field equipment to make sure that it looks good, and you want it as much as you can behind your back. Make sure that your K98 pouches are a centimeter away from the belt buckle, so not too far apart, but not too close. We'll then put in my Y-straps. So we'll then just sling it over my head and onto my back. We'll then hook up the two hooks to the K98 pouches. And then we'll hook up the back strap to my belt in between the two straps of the bread bag.
between the first one and the middle one, that is. Awesome. So last but not least, we'll be putting on my gas mask canister, which this should be the last thing that you put before your helmet, of course. And then you will then strap it onto the belt. This can be difficult, especially if you have a gas mask in there, such as I do, but it is doable. We will then put on my helmet, and then we will grab my Kar-98K. However, I have noticed that I forgot to put on the canteen, so your canteen will already be on your bread bag. And that is it. So thank you for watching, and have a good one.